The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Oh, look who we have. It's a beautiful thing. Look at our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We are taken by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But yeah. Holy, I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Don't make assumptions. Communicate with clarity. Communicate with others as clearly as you can to avoid misunderstanding, sadness, and drama. If all humans would communicate with impeccability of the word, all our relationships would change. There'd be no walls, no violence, and no misunderstandings. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 16, NASDAQ is up 17, S&P's up 4. Gold contract up $6.20, trading at $15.62 an ounce. Silver down 2 cents, $17.80 an ounce. Light sweet crude off $1.20, $55.54 a barrel. Notes and bonds. You get the 10-year up 9 ticks, trading 129.26. 30-year up 25 ticks, trading 159.19. And King Dollar. King Dollar up 158 ticks, trading 97.685. The euro is at 110. The yen is out here at 109.5, and the pound is at 131 to one U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. Pretty wild, folks. Bottom line is that with these highs, they're not finished being tested. That's the way this thing is looking right now. What you had out here is that we got S&Ps, NASDAQ, as well as the Index 100 had got to new highs yesterday. Inside the SPY, that was 332.95. Bottom line, didn't have the volume up there, but, you know, it is what it is. Today, what did you do? You backed down, got into 329, rejected lower price. Bottom line, you're going to have light volume on the downdraft here. This is going to go right after the highs once again, because what you have here also is that you have a holiday week. You're coming into the Friday of the holiday week, and the markets have been basically edging higher all week. And your probability goes up dramatically when that happens. And in this particular case, you know, we can make the case that you've just gone straight up since, let's see, December 3rd. December 3rd is? Yeah, December 3rd. That was the last time we had any type of pullback. You can actually say you've gone straight up since October 3rd. It is what it is. NDX 100, the three Qs. Three Qs rejected the low out here today. That's going to go right after its highs also. And it looks like the NDX 100, let me see all the composites setting up here. The NDX 100 and the SPYs look like they're going to close at all-time highs, meaning a closing price, not an intraday price. The composite, let's see, the composite actually could do it too. So the composite, yeah, 9,400. The bottom line is that, you know, we got to 9,439 yesterday, but you end up closing out at 9,383. And this composite does not look like it wants to back down whatsoever. After the close out here, we're going to get Intel tonight. We'll see where that shakes out. The chip company, the chip stocks, they're on a tear. You get CTXS is up 7.5% right now on $9 trading. 128, that's Citrix Systems. Netflix is up 5% or $16.83. Let me look at this. So this is like a one-day delayed action on Netflix. Look at that thing. Holy cow. So yesterday in Netflix comes out with this numbers, goes from 336 rather, to 323. Opens this morning at 326 and just takes off like a rocket ship. Bottom line, big number. Talk about a one-day delay. Crazy. Expedia. Expedia's up 3.4%, and you have Western Digital trading up 3%. Taken away from it, Fox is down 4%. You got all the cable stations are getting hit. Interesting. And then you got Comcast down 3.7%. Align Technology is off 3%. Inside the Dow Industrials, the strength versus the weakness inside the Dow Industrials. And evidently, you know, we had the Dow was down. Boeing is putting some big positive points inside the Dow. Dow's still down, but only 28 points. The Dow had been trading down there almost like 180, 170 points earlier. Boeing's putting 54 positive points in. Home Depot, 11. Big Mac, 10. Taken away from it. Travelers Insurance down 40, putting 45 negative points. United Health, 14. Disney, 13. We get over to, we take a look at the gold market. Gold wants higher price, folks. Bottom line, it is pushing its swing points out here, and it has volume behind the move. 34,000 contracts we've done out here. The low for the day is 1551. The highs, 1567. You're pushing into the swing. You get volume into the swing. This is setting up a to completion of a complex ABC structure on the way up. We go take a look at the GDX. GDX is going to need, this would be the equities inside the gold market. It's going to need more volume. Right now, you're down 7 cents. You've done 23 million shares, and that's going to need a lot more volume. No two ways about that. We take a look at Franco-Nevada. Now, Franco-Nevada been breaking highs, went to an all-time high. Yesterday, still up here. You're talking, let's see, 109.11. Now, we hit that today. That is a all-time high. Notes and bonds. We go take a look at that note and bond market, and they are just refusing to back off also. And they have volume behind the move. So, you know, you get some divergences out here inside the note and bond, well, inside the general market, meaning when you take a look at equities, the futures, the notes, the bonds, and then the dollar. Notes and bonds, they've been the most consistent. They just continue to want higher price, lower yield. That's how this thing is shaken out. The high that was reached on the 8th of January was 130.06 inside the 10-year. I expect we're going to see that hit. Right now, the 10-year is yielding 1.733. And if we go over and take a look at the 30-year, what you're going to see is the 30-year already took out the high of the high volume high of January 8th. That was 159.19. We went to 159.31 today. Right now, we are laying out at 159.18. Now, the way these are set up to go all the way back to the highs that were generated out here in October, in November, and if that's what we're talking, you're talking a 30-year at 165. So it's a very large number. Whatever is out here is saying that interest rates are still going to lower price. Dow Industrials down 18, Nasdaq's up 16, S&P's up 3.5. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.